thing. It's the same thing. If you go outside, it's a really cold day, and you exhale, you feel a little bit of your breath. See the cloud? That's the same thing we're seeing with our dolphins when they breathe. And their air is basically inside of them. When they exhale, and they exhale exclusively, they get rid of about 50% of the air in their lungs. People only get rid of 20% of the air in our lungs. Dolphins only get rid of 80%, they would refill it back up in less than a second. So they can be ready to keep right on swimming and not get any water in there. So if you see what looks like a stump, it's actually just like condensation. It's the same thing. You go outside, it's really cold, and you go, you're going to see your breath. It's the same thing you're seeing there. Dolphins are also warm-blooded. So for people, our core temperature has got to stay the same. So like right now, most of you are wearing kind of some long-sleeve shirts or short sleeves. We're not seeing a lot of layers on because it's pretty warm outside. But if back in like January, if you were here, you'd see people in coats and jackets and pants and scarves and hats. That's because you're trying to keep nice and warm because the air gets so cold. Well, for dolphins, instead of putting on clothing, they actually change what's called their blubber layer. So if they are in really cold water, eat a lot of food, and they build up a huge layer of fat, that actually keeps them nice insulated from the water. If the water gets really warm, they don't eat as much, they get skinnier. They're going to get a thinner layer. That way they get rid of some of that heat to the water. Now dolphins also, they actually give birth to live young. So when our dolphins are pregnant, they're pregnant for about a year. They only give birth to one calf. It's actually one of the ways you can tell a male and a female dolphin is if you look on their belly, a male dolphin looks like it's an exclamation point. He's got a long line of the dot near the end. Right now, our two male dolphins, Bo and Foster, are both in the back there. Our female dolphins are out front here, so if you see their bellies, they look like they have a division sign. They have a long line, a little line above, and a little line below. When they give birth, that calf's going to come out tail first. It comes out of that long line, but those little lines, that's where they nurse. Dolphins nurse their young. They have a milk just like people drink milk, only dolphin milk is a lot more fat to it because they're only about 30 pounds when they're first born. By the time they're about a month old, they want to be 100 pounds, so they need a lot of calories to get that weight. Now, dolphins also have hair when they're first born. Now, if you look at the mouth, I don't see hair. No, right? It's kind of a trick question. Dolphins' hair doesn't last at all. They only grow from the mustache and the goatee. They have a few bristly hairs across their rostrum and a few bristly hairs on the bottom. They drop out within the first couple of minutes, hours, or days. But it's long enough to count for being a mammal. But even though they have these characteristics in common with us, they live in a totally aquatic world, so they've got to be a little different as well, right? They would have called adaptations even if they didn't allow dolphins to thrive in that aquatic world. So today, they're going to have our six female dolphins show off a few of these adaptations for all of you. So the first thing we're going to talk about is their bodies. Dolphins have some pretty amazing fins. So where our hands are, dolphins have what we call pectoral fins. They're these small fins on the side. Now they don't have the ability to open their fingers anymore. They actually have five bones that just like our hand, but they're fused together. They're connected all the time. Now this allows dolphins to actually steer. If you think about it, when you swim in the water, you never swim with your fingers spread wide open. Instead, you swim with your fingers closed. So if they're closed, the dolphins can get into them further. Now they have a lot of mobility in those small fins on the side. They can move them back and forth. They lock the fins against the turn, and they can direct the water. They can do a turn on the dive. They can also use them to flap the surface of the water. Very good to communicate. And not only the dog gets scared of those pectoral fins, but they also have a dorsal fin on their back. So that dorsal fin actually acts like the heel of a boat. So it allows the dolphins to keep themselves upright in the water and choose where they want to swim. Now as our dolphins come around, I notice the dorsal fin's all a little bit different. So this is Jade in the front. She's the largest dorsal fin. You can see it lean a little bit to one side. Nani's the one coming up next to her. Her dorsal fin's a lot darker and has some little notches at the out of the back. And this is Spirit. Hers is a little bit smaller than the other two. In fact, no two dolphin dorsal fins are exactly alike. They're like people's fingerprints. That's one of the ways researchers can actually tell dolphins apart. So if they see a dolphin out in the ocean, they'll take a picture of that dorsal fin or the tail, and they'll compare it to all of the pictures they've taken, which allows them to identify individual animals. So our doctor is going to show you, it allows them to direct get that water. They can even do somersaults in the water, tell them where you're going. Observation deck. Now this is different than fish. So if you see a fish, like a shark, they're moving from side to side. But if you see a mammal, like a dolphin, or a whale, they're going to be moving up and down. So that's one of the ways you can tell the difference if you see a dorsal fin.
Right back in.